So I had a request the other day off of YouTube. The gentleman wanted to know, how do you regulate the TIG welder? How do you regulate the machine? What are all the knobs and buttons and dials for? Well, this is my Miller sine wave. It's a TIG welder, and it's also a stick welder or an arc welder. So you just turn that guy on. It's got to let it boot up, let it wake itself up. The main control on this is the amperage knob, and you can see right here, it's sitting at 7 amps right now. You would turn that up to, say, 15 amps if you were going to be welding something like a real thin gauge aluminum, you know, a thin gauge steel, you know, like a 20 gauge, 22, 24 gauge, you know, aluminum foil, I mean, really, really thin stuff. Turn that voltage, turn that amperage way, way down. You could boost it up to, say, like 35 amps for things like 16 gauge steel, 8 inch plate. You might want to go a little higher. You know, say up to about 45 amps for like 8 inch plate. We're going to get into quarter inch. Oh my God. Let's bump that puppy up to about 65, 70 amps. A little more heat out of it, get a little more penetration out of it. Now, you're going to get really, really crazy, and you're going to get into some 1 inch plate. You could turn that sucker up to 150, 160 amps. You really wouldn't want to weld 1-inch plate with a TIG welder. That's when you would shut your machine off. You would switch the knob over to stick welding. Set up your stick welder. Turn it back on, and you're ready to go. You know, adjust your voltage, right? 100 and remember now, I am not a certified welder. I am self-trained in all of this. So the numbers that I'm spouting, I'm sure some of you won't agree with, but they kind of work for me. But for stick welding, 100 amps, 120 amps, 130 amps for, you know, like 1-inch plate. That's kind of all there is, really. It does have a pulse function for the stick or for the TIG welder. And the pulse function is really kind of fun to play with, and it's just like it says, it makes the arc pulse. So if you're welding on thinner materials, you get a spike in your voltage or in your amperage. You weld, and then all of a sudden it drops off, so you don't burn through. It allows you to weld on thinner materials. It makes your weld look a little better. Nice function. That's about it. Now you just gotta practice. Lots and lots of practice. Hope that helps. See you next time.